The Ryup Engines Museum was built in 1868 and once supplied clean drinking water to the whole of Sunderland and surrounding areas. But after 100 years of continuous use, in 1967 it ceased operation. The museum itself still holds events around bank holidays each year, but for the rest of the time it's closed. But today I've been invited inside a building for a bit of a tour, of which most locals have only ever seen the outside.
I'm coming to meet Keith Bell, the chairman, who said he's very much looking forward to opening the doors this weekend to celebrate the station's 150th anniversary.
Hello Keith, how are you? You alright?
I am. Welcome to Ryup Engines Museum in what's going to be a very special year for us.
It is. It's nice and warm in here. I'm glad I took my jacket off. This is lovely. This is what I'm talking about.
So it was built 150 years ago to supply water to Wearside. It did that for 100 years and we've actually run the engines as a museum for 50 years. And we've got some steam ready to show you how that works in a short while.
That's fantastic. Can we go for a look around then?
Please, yes.
After you. So what have we got here? This is the control centre, isn't
it? It certainly is, Will. When the engines are running, they run totally automatically. But in order to start that process off, we have to open the valves manually. Right. And that's quite a heavy process. But you'll see that we might even get you involved in that process if you like. This is a wonderful vantage point, Will. You can see from here the beautiful and ornate columns and the entablature which help to hold the beams up. We've got a special chap upstairs who will show you the beams, and then he's today's engine driver. So Peter will tell you all about the beams and then we'll go and start the engine.
Hello Peter, how are you?
Hello,
all right?
Fine, thanks.
This is a very good view from the top, isn't it?
It is, yes. This is our beam engine, yes. They were lifting up on airframes. And then the building was built around them.
Stay with us shortly, we'll be continuing the tour, plus I'll be learning how to start this humongous engine.